Hello friends, I am Vishal Wadkar. Today we will discuss these points: tractive effort, specific energy output, specific energy consumption, factors affecting specific energy consumption, and coefficient of adhesion. First point is tractive effort. The tractive effort is defined as the force developed by the traction unit at the wheel for moving the traction unit. The tractive effort performs the following functions: it provides necessary linear and angular acceleration to the train mass. Also, it overcomes the gravity component of the weight of the train. It overcomes the wind and frictional resistance of the train, and it overcomes curl resistance. Now, the tractive effort for acceleration. Here, this is the tractive effort for acceleration. It is the force required to give linear acceleration to the train, as well as required for equivalent additional mass of rotating mass. It is given by Fa equals to 28.3 into We into alpha, where W is the weight of locomotive in tons and We is the dead weight, that is when train is in rest condition. Next is tractive effort required to balance the gravitational pull. Here, when train is on an up gradient, the gravity component of dead weight of train, which is parallel to the track, will be responsible for the train to come down. To prevent this, the tractive effort has to be applied in upward direction, whose magnitude is given by Fg equals to W into g, where g is the gradient. Next is tractive effort to overcome the train resistance. The train resistance consists of all forces which oppose the motion of the train on level track. These resistances are classified as internal and external. The tractive effort required to overcome these train resistance is given as Fr equals to R into W, where R is the total resistance offered by the train. The tractive effort is also required to overcome the curl resistance, and it is given as Fc equals to 0.4 into C into W. And total tractive effort is given as total tractive effort, that is Ft, is equal to tractive effort for acceleration, that is Fa, plus tractive effort required to balance gravitational pull, that is Fg, and tractive effort to overcome train resistance, that is Fr, and tractive effort required to overcome curl resistance, that is Fc. Here, total tractive effort is given. Next, the specific energy consumption. The specific energy consumption is defined as energy consumed in watt hours per ton kilometers of train. The specific energy output of driving wheels is divided by overall efficiency of transmission, gear and motor. Then we will get specific energy consumption. It is the ratio of specific energy output at driving wheels to the overall efficiency of transmission, gear and motor. To find out specific energy consumption, first we have to find specific energy output at driving wheels. Here specific energy output is given as, it is the ratio of total energy output of driving wheels divided by weight of train into distance covered by the train. Here the numerator is total energy output of driving wheels, and it is given by the energy output of driving axles to accelerate the train, that is EA, plus energy output of driving axles to overcome the gradient, that is EG, and energy output of driving axles to overcome the friction, that is EF. So then we will get total energy output, and from that we will get specific energy output, from which we will calculate the specific energy consumption of the train. Here some factors are given which will affect the specific energy consumption. First is retardation and acceleration values. For greater values of acceleration and retardation, the specific energy consumption will be less. Next is gradient. Steep gradient causes more specific energy consumption, even though regenerative braking is employed. Next is distance between the stops. Next, train resistance. For more train resistance, the specific energy consumption will be more. And last point is type of train equipment. Here the greater overall efficiency of axles, then specific energy consumption will be less. The last point is coefficient of adhesion. It is given by mu A. The increasing torque exerted by the motor can increase tractive effort at the driving wheels, but after certain limit, any increase in motor torque does not increase the tractive effort. The maximum value of tractive effort at which the driving wheels will not slip, it depends upon the dead weight over the driving axle. Therefore, tractive effort F is proportional to weight of locomotive. Here F equals to mu A into W, or it is also given by F equal to 9.81 into 1000 into mu A. The unit of tractive effort is in tons, where mu A is called as the coefficient of adhesion. To increase the tractive effort of locomotive, HP of the traction motor has to increase, along with weight on the driving wheels has to be increased. Last point, that is the factors affecting the coefficient of adhesion. Various factors influence the adhesion, and these are classified as given. First is the track, in that the presence of oil, dust or dry rails. That improves the adhesion. Next is mechanical parts of locomotive. in that suspension and damping arrangement in the bogie, if it is better, then coefficient of adhesion increases. Also, if moment of inertia of revolving masses of bogie is greater, then coefficient of adhesion improves. And last point is electrical parts of locomotive. In case of DC locomotive, tractive effort produced may be above adhesion limit, whereas in case of AC locomotive, tractive effort is below the adhesion limit. The remaining points we will see in next lecture. Thank you.